Today at Mellon Arena, Marc-Andre Fleury makes his long-awaited first start since suffering a high ankle sprain on December 6th in Calgary. And he faces former teammates Mark Recchi, Colby Armstrong, Eric Christensen, and the rest of the Atlanta Thrashers next on FSN. There are some games that you should win, and there are some games that you must win. You could say that for the Pittsburgh Penguins today, both of those situations apply as they host the Atlanta Thrashers. It's uncanny how, right after a big deal, two teams will inevitably play one another, and that's the case here today. Penguins just making the big deal with the Thrashers at the trade deadline, and the former Penguins are back here on home ice.
Yeah, you know, and when you play your old team there, you certainly have that feeling, a little nervousness, but you want to get out there. Colby will want to crack somebody. Some guys will want to score a goal like Pascal Dupuis did in his outing, but there's a lot of kind of feeling yourself out. The best thing to do is to just get it going. Dupuis knows about it today. He's been traded a couple of times, but Colby Armstrong, it's a new thing for him. Quickly back in his hometown of Pittsburgh, and he's getting banged, you know, he's getting all that adulation from the fans. Eric Christensen as well had a shootout yesterday afternoon with Atlanta where he was denied, and of course there's a wrecking ball. The wrecking ball has not played as a visitor on the Mellon Arena ice since 2004, and he's almost a point of game guy. He still wants to show he didn't want to go.
Cora behind the goal for Malkin in front. Gutcher, a shot and a great save by Perry Lehtinen right there. It's like a Gutcher, and now the Penguins poke the puck into the goal. Ryan Malone gets it because they didn't blow the whistle for Lehtinen. The puck was still available, and Malone found it and poked it in to give the Penguins a 1-0 lead.
So the Penguins take advantage of a makeshift ex-Penguin line, and Christensen, Armstrong, and Recchi. And at the end of that shift, Lehtinen looks around. The puck comes loose. Mark Malone digs it out from between Lennon's pads. I can't believe the officials did not blow it here. This puck is underneath the goaltender. He looks around, and then long after, it seems, Malone finds it between the legs, curls and drags it out, puts it in the wide open cage. Boy, not a lot of help. Ryan Malone was fishing there.
Was quickly moving out. Maxime Talbot down the wing. Talbot with a great move to the goal. He scores! Maxime Talbot with his first goal in 19 games makes it 2-0 Pittsburgh.
Well, that's as great a move as you're ever going to want to see. Maxime Talbot, oh my, what a move. Talbot has been stale, and the Penguins come out firing, putting the hammer down. Look at the speed. McCarthy, where's he going? He's on I-79. And Maxime Talbot flies into the boards. What a spectacular backhand shot, getting Lehtinen off his goalpost. Hey, that doesn't hurt. Normally, if you go into the boards, that hurts. But when you score a goal and light the lamp in that kind of fashion.
Eric Christensen will shoot first. Perrin and Kovalchuk for Atlanta.
And these Thrashers, I don't know if Lehtinen went over and got some scouting reports, Bob. But you know, they don't know who the shooters are going to be. But I can tell you that those guys that are on the bench right now for the Thrashers who played for Pittsburgh, they know what Pierre Secora's bread and butter is. He's great on the backhand on the breakaways.
Well, you know, he did some funny things. I'm Boston University when they had a contest the other day. I don't know if he'll do that or not against Lehtinen. I don't want to give it away.
Well, he's going wide. Here he comes. Fakes a shot. Goes to the backhand. Oh, he put it off the goalpost. And he had him beat.
Yeah, I like the fake shot, and that's what he did at BU. And he won the shootout for the Penguins by faking a shot and trying to freeze the goalie. Look at all the room there. A lot of room.
And Letang had a beautiful move, too, which we can maybe talk about when he gets a chance to shoot. Eric Christensen starts it off for the Thrashers. A look out here. What will he do against Marc-Andre Fleury? His shot, he rung it off the post. That's surprising. We haven't seen Christensen pull the trigger like that very often.
No.
He must have been overthinking it, almost thinking, well, Fleury knows all my moves, so I'll give him a completely different look.
Yeah, he thought Fleury was going to cheat to his forehand. So he thought there'd be a lot of room over the glove hand, and he didn't hit it. He hit the goalpost.
Now, see if Letang, he did this little move, Bob, where he kind of stopped on his skates. So I'm thinking he was going to come to a stop and then kept going. It was a beautiful move he made at BU. That's his bread and butter to the backhand. He scores. Letang, so good on the shootouts.
You got to get it up over the pads of Lehtinen. He's one of the longest leg goaltenders in the National Hockey League. He's going to be able to put his pads post to post. and he throws them enough. But when he made the move, the key was getting the pad, getting the puck elevated, and that's what he did against Letton. Here comes Perrin.
Well, he comes with speed. Little Eric Perrin blowing in on Fleury. And he can't beat Fleury.
Yeah, lost the puck. He tried to stop and turn it back to the forehand. He tried to use a lot of speed, come in, throw on the brakes, turn it from backhand to forehand. He just lost the puck right there as he was trying to turn it back to the forehand.
Well, Ruutu can win it here.
Yeah, Ruutu likes to open up the pads of a goaltender, and there's some big legs here. Let's see what happens.
Jarkko Ruutu, he really comes slowly. Look at him. He's using every inch of ice available to him and not letting it. His shot, he missed the goal, and he's not happy about it either. He missed it by a wide margin.
No, he's not. No, and on the road, he was going from board side to board side. He tried to put the goalie asleep. It didn't work.
Well, it's up to Kovalchuk to keep it alive. He scored in the shootout yesterday. Ilya Kovalchuk, second in the league with 42 goals. In on Fleury. And Fleury makes the save, and the Penguins win and get the extra point and move into first place in the Atlantic Division.
And Marc-Andre Fleury, congratulated by his teammates, five straight victories for the Flower, and all-important 2 points in the standing, Steggy. And that puts him in a tie right now, the Pittsburgh Penguins, with Montreal atop that heap. And you see they move 1 point ahead right now, the New Jersey Devils.
Penguins are in that spot where you want to be. You want to get that home ice advantage by winning your division. That's really the key. Yeah, you'd love to win the conference. But if the Penguins could be one of those top two seeds, they would love it. So this is a big point that Marc-Andre Fleury helped the Penguins get today in earning our McDonald's player of the game. So a huge win for the Penguins as they go back to the road for games against Tampa, Florida, and Washington.
You know, you get that acceptance, too, with the teammates. For the new guys on the ice with Dupuy and Gill and Hossa, their first victory in a Penguin uniform. And, you know, that love and feeling's back, and the Penguins will go on the road.
And they really needed it. I mean, they got off to a good start today. It's tough. You score two goals in the first 2:09. You figure, well, we're going to have a nice big party here today. It didn't turn out that way. It was a tough point to earn, the extra point. The Penguins were very happy to get the win here today the way they did. And the record now 37-23-7. Next broadcast Tuesday against Tampa Bay from Tampa at 7:30. Our coverage continues right now with Paul Alexander and Jay Caulfield on FSN Live. For Dan Potash and Bob Airey and our entire crew here in Pittsburgh, this is Paul Steigerwald. Have a good night, everybody.